Hi everyone, today we will try to do some technical analysis of commodities that are traded on Commodity Stock Exchange in India. This exchange name is NCDEX.com. So we'll go end-to-end processing. I mean, this is my very first video. If you have any comments, any suggestions, please let me know. So I'll not take much of your time and let's start. So I'll just tell you about NCDEX. NCDEX. So this is the National Stock, National Commodity and Derivatives Exchange. We will go to market data and future prices. So this is the place from where we are going to download the data that is required for all of our analysis. This is the list of all the commodities that are being traded here. So for me, the most, I had gone through a few of them, but the most interesting for me was soybean, because it's been traded for really long and it has a lot of fluctuations and we can find some interesting trends in it. Let's go with soybean. And then so for every time, if you know how futures and futures are traded, so these are the expiry dates for soybean. So it ranges from 2004, I suppose, January 2004 until the recent May 2016. So this is what we are going to do. We are going to download a file. So for example, if I select soybean from here and if I select May 2016 as in, or for that matter, let's take it as what December 2015 as expiry date. Click on details and it will show us the date of trade, the previous close price, the open price for today, the high price on that particular day, the low price on that particular day, the close price for that particular day, the number of volumes or the number of trades, the number of commodity units that have been traded. Open interest is basically the number of people or the number of orders that were interested, which includes either buy or sell, both are included. And traded value, as you say, and this is the delivery center. Delivery center is not of much importance to us. This is, but it's okay. And what we are going to do is we are going to click on this export to CSV button. Then the file would be downloaded on our machine. And this is what we are going to do for all these expiry dates. So it's, of course, it's not possible to do through a small, manual programming or manually. It has to be done through our Python. So I have written a small script using Selenium. So let's have a look at it. So we know that this is the URL that we need to hit. This is the dropdown we have to click on and then select this value, soybean, S-Y-B-E-A-N-D-E-D-I-R. And then for expiry date, we have to select values which are going to loop through, then one by one. And then we are going to click on details. And then we are going to click on export to CSV. So let's go straight about it. So we are going to use IPython. I'll close this for the time being, or I'll just show it to you the values that we are going to see through inspect. So, or let me come back to you on this later on. So we are going to quit the web page now, and we are going to start with IPython, which I'm going to use it as my IDE or a place from where I'm going to execute the Python script. So let's start IPython. If you know that the latest IPython is Jupyter, so let's go for it. If you don't know that there's a lot of help available, you can always look into it. So Jupyter notebook is the command to start a notebook IPython notebook or Jupyter notebook, whatever you call it as. It will start with localhost 8888 is the default port for Jupyter or IPython. And then we are going to go with the place where I have my IPython notebooks. So let me start with it. So we would be needing a few things here. We need to import WebDriver from Selenium. We need to import time and we need to import SH utility. So as I said, there was a drop down, or let me show it to you in NCDEX.com. Future prices. And what we need to do is we need to select, and we need to select one of these values of expiry date. So what I have done is I have just selected all these month and year values in an array here, starting from January 2004 until December 2016. I'll just let you know the details of this. So this is basically a list of all the values that I can find in that particular drop down of expiry date. I have defined a small function which takes the value of month. Basically, this is the value that I'm going to pass it to January 2009, January 2010, and so on and so forth. What it will do is, DD commodity, basically this is the name of the drop-down value, that this is the ID. I'll just show it to you in few seconds. So what it's gonna do is, it's gonna select the value that I have passed through this month, and then it's gonna go and click on the button details, and then it's gonna click on the button export CSV. How do I know that this is the name of the buttons? Go here, right click on details and say inspect element. And basically, if you look at it, it's an input ID, and the ID or the identifier of this particular button is CT100 content placeholder 3 button pack. And this is what we are going to do. We are going to find the element by find element by ID. That's the element ID I have passed into, and the activity that we need to do is click on it. Again, the same thing, what we will have to find out what is the ID for export button. Do exactly the same thing. Right click on this button and say inspect element. Just be sure that it highlights it correctly. Yes. So the ID of that particular button is CT100 content placeholder 3 button export. And that's what we did. So the particular file, once we click on that particular button, let's hit on that button. The file would be downloaded to our defined location. And the name of the file is going to be future price_214.csv. We'll come back to that later on. Okay, so the file has been downloaded. And once the file has been downloaded, what we need to do is basically we need to move it from default download location to a particular directory where we are going to process everything. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this file from this particular location. So the name of the file, always whenever it's going to be downloaded, is going to be feature price underscore 214.csv. What I'm going to do is I'm going to rename it to soybean underscore the month for which I have downloaded the file. That is stored as a file name which comes from my dates dot CSV. So for example, if I'm going to download it for February 2015, then the name of the file is going to be soybean underscore fav 2000 blah 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 dot CSV. So this is what we are going to do in a loop. So let's go ahead and give a try. But before that, we have to make few things sure that this particular directory exists. Otherwise, the whole script will fail. So let's go and check if this particular folder exists. So this is users, my name of my login, Python directory, NCDEX directory, and soybean directory. So let me go to computer, user, MVP, Python, NCDEX, soybean. Okay, let me delete whatever is there here. So the directory exists and it's empty. Okay. So these were the two functions, and how we are going to call to these two functions is basically we are going to hit this URL, and once we hit this URL, we are going to call this particular two functions for every value in this dates. So download file and then rename file. So every time we are going to download a file, then we are going to rename it and move it into a particular folder, and then we are going to move to the next value and then again download the file. So let's start. So this is basically importing. If we have problems importing, that means something was wrong or this particular install is or particular utility is not been installed. You can install it simply by going on the command prompt and saying pip space install space, let's say Selenium, and it will be installed for you. But we can have a different session for that if you want, but which is out of scope for this particular session. Here I'm just going to define an array of all the months that we are going to look value for. Here we are defining a function which downloads the file based on the values that we want to click on the buttons, or the values that we are going to select from a dropdown. And these are the IDs of those particular dropdown. These are the values of which we are going to select in the dropdown. I think no, this time slip is not required. We will reduce it to one. And this is the function which moves basically the downloaded file to a particular location. So let's go ahead and start this program. And we can see that because I said it should be a Chrome driver, it opened a Chrome driver. Oops. And it has started downloading. You can see June, July, August. It has, let us see if these particular files are being downloaded. So if I go to my download folder, and you can see that every time it downloads and moves out, downloads and moves out. And it is moving to a place where we asked him to, NCDEX, soybean, and you can see that the files are being downloaded here. It's going to take very long time, guys. So I say that we this is, we end this part, and further processing we can do as part two. Thank you very much for your patience and subscribing to my video. If you liked my video, hit a like button and subscribe to my channel. We'll see you on the other side of this video in part two. Bye for now.